exotic animals as pets. So did you guys know that backyard breeding today is a multi-million dollar industry? And there's very little legal protection for the animals being bred in people's backyards. And the majority of state laws only require the breeder to obtain a permit to be able to breed these kinds of animals. So today I chose to discuss this topic with you guys because I feel that everyone in this room has once wanted a pet tiger or a monkey, a lizard, even a turtle. I feel incredible because as destructive human beings on this planet, I believe it's our job to conserve what is left of nature through research and knowledge of the dangers of capturing a wild animal and keeping it as a pet. I thoroughly researched this topic and I feel informed enough to share information with you guys. Okay, so the points I will be going over are the dangers of owning a wild animal as a pet to the owner and to the people that come into contact with this animal. I will also share the dangers of to the wild animal being held as a pet, and I will mention things about the exotic pet trade. So, dangers and diseases. Some of the dangers that come from owning an exotic animal would be like if I kept a tiger in my backyard and my neighbor, you know, was jumping over the fence to get his ball, I'm pretty sure my tiger would attack. Another thing is that they're escape artists. A regular cage won't hold in a wild animal, so they can escape and they don't come into human contact a lot, so they can hurt other people. And some diseases that some wild animals carry that aren't necessarily deadly to them but can be fatal to a human being with a weakened immune system, a young child or an older adult, are rabies, salmonella, monkeypox, Ebola, and herpes B virus. There are some vaccines, but many times the symptoms aren't shown until it's too late. And these diseases are also transferred either through the animal species, the animal saliva, or the animal blood. So now that we know about some dangers and diseases, I will next talk about an animal's food and habitat. Okay, so no matter how much money we have or how much space we think we have, we cannot possibly replicate nature. So we can't give the tiger miles or acres of land because we don't have that. Or these cages, they're not sufficient enough for a tiger. A tiger, a lion, any big cat is used to having a big territory and they will fight other animals for it. That's what they're used to, that's what they're bred for. So we shouldn't try to keep them in a cage or keep them alone in solitude just for our satisfaction or entertainment. Food. In the zoos, in privately held animals or organizations, we usually give animals meat or like fish that's already dead, it's already been cut, and there's probably some hormones in it. And we have to modify the food for their specific needs. But if they're in the wild, we wouldn't need to do this. They'd be able to hunt, you know. And yeah, it's sad, you know, oh my god, we're gonna kill the zebra or whatever. But it's the cycle of life, and we shouldn't mess with it. Okay, so now that we know a little bit about the diet and habitat, I will be talking about the exotic pet trade and why we shouldn't be a part of it. As I said before, breeding is a multi-million dollar industry, and this is also included in the exotic pet trade. When people realize that tigers, lions, monkeys, lizards, turtles, parrots are making, you know, hundreds of dollars, they're going to start breeding them in their backyards, and the conditions they keep them in are pretty cool. As you can see here, some people transported snakes in water bottles. They keep a bunch of animals in tight spaces. It's really inhumane and sad for the animal. These people, they don't care what you do with the animal. I can buy it online for, what, $200? And they don't care if I skin it, if I cook it, if I eat it. I don't know. part of the exotic pet trade. I hope that through this presentation, I didn't scare you, or I don't mean for you to dislike exotic animals. They are beautiful creatures, and they're amazing and intelligent creatures like humans. I do believe we can learn a lot from them, but at a distance. I don't think we should have them in our backyards to learn.